Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to the joinDOTA MLG Pro League. We have not today facing up against Union Gaming, an absolute classic to start out the night of Dota. We have the two Peruvian teams, arguably the two best teams. I wouldn't even say arguably. Probably the best two teams coming out of South America, or at least consistently best. Anyway, not today. Definitely leading the pack so far, as the last time that we saw them was at the Summit, where they were able to clinch their victory over Complexity in the finals in order to make it to the Summit. The last time these two faced up against each other in a more minor tournament was, of course, the Battle of Americas, where Not Today did take that 1-2-0. But Not Today do have themselves a new roster, and we're looking at it right here. You still see some of the old names, Smash as well as good old Mystico, are still playing for Not Today. These two have been at it for quite a long time, but Ifrit, Slarky, as well as Rowlers, is what I'm calling him. I'm presuming that's supposed to be an R, a fancy way to put an R. Rowlers, I have all joined the team. And now it's not an all-Peruvian affair anymore. That's probably an interesting addition as well. Ifrit is actually Mexican. So we now have a little bit more variety when it comes to our Crunchman. Now, Union Gaming, they've only been actually, they made a very significant roster change as well. Not as early. This Not Today roster did change up, I think it was like a week ago. The Union Gaming roster changed up, it was probably 3 months ago. I think it was sometime in the like December period. It was right before the summit was going on that... they had Leo Style, Greedy, as well as Z-Talk. Greedy, rather. Were all added in. So those are your new additions for Union Gaming. So we have kind of new rosters on the two teams that have been probably the most consistently dominant of the in the South American region. Of course, you look a little bit farther back, maybe close to the early days of Dota 2, you do have Pain Gaming, which are still kind of around their Brazilian squad. I don't know if King RD even still plays on Pain Gaming or not, but either way. Either way. Oh, looks like I'm actually just now getting word. Unfortunately, our second game of the night, Void Boys versus Fire, is going to be rescheduled. So, unfortunately... we're going to be starting off with starting and ending on this South American matchup. So let's get into it, shall we? We've got the Juggernaut and Vengeful Spirit picked up by Not Today. Ogre Magi, Queen of Pain, and the Wisp. Beep Boop. Going to be the third pick now for Union Gaming. So far, nothing real special. The Queen of Pain and Ogre Magi early pickup. I like the fact that they still picking up the Ogre Magi. Ogre Magi kind of dropped out of the pool for quite some time. It's kind of interesting how he's just completely gone where he was once so dominant as a support, even though nothing's really changed about him all that much. Most of his strength is still there. So I do like to see that this Ogre Magi is still a pickup for Union Gaming. Not Today, looking like a very standard setup in the current meta. Juggernaut, of course, being one of the most highly valued cores out there, and followed up by one of the most highly valued supports, the Vengeful Spirit. Lion. Now, the Not Today team, well, it'll be interesting to see whether or not they change up their drafts at all. Mystico is still drafting, but of course, adding in three new heroes or three new players may not be as comfortable as with what's been run with in the past. We're going to have a West Tiny strat, though, coming out from Union Gaming. Wasn't entirely sure if this is going to be a Tiny game or not. Tiny is actually pretty damn good versus Juggernaut because he's naturally tanky and isn't going to be just popped by one Omni Slash. So the Tiny was definitely a viable pickup here, but we have seen some other heroes being run with the Wisp rather than just the traditional Tiny. An early Broodmother pickup, though, by Not Today. They do already have both of their supports locked in, and neither one of them has, like, amazing AoE to clear through the Spiderling. So I guess there's that. But that being said, both the cores of Union Gaming, both the Queen of Pain as well as the Tiny, can clear through those little Broodlings pretty quickly. As they both have some nice AoE, so I'm a bit surprised by this, honestly. as if anything, I would have waited for the Broodmother last pick, but maybe not today. Fearful of Broodmother being banned out. Now, just because the Broodmother is countered by the cores, right? Just because the Broodmother is going to be addressed and there isn't a total lack of AoE on the side of Union Gaming doesn't mean the Broodmother is necessarily a bad pick. Broodmother still brings a lot to the table and is able to draw a lot of attention to that bottom lane, presumably where she's going to be as the offlaner here. And should still be able to draw a lot of attention and also consistently push down towers. Despite the fact that Union Gaming do have some heroes to deal with them, they will have to move around the map eventually, right? That's the big power of Broodmother is you lock one enemy hero to sit in that lane constantly. Otherwise, their towers are just going to start dropping like flies. Brewmaster is going to be banned away by Union Gaming while the Tidehunter is taken out by Not Today, completely behind that Tidehunter ban. As that guy would be the last link here for Union Gaming as an offlaner, able to set up the relocate in with a big AoE Ravage. But instead, they're going to go for some solid single target lockdown in the Legion Commander. And now this kind of gives us a question mark here. What is the lanes going to be? Because originally, I was kind of expecting just a regular Wiz Tiny safe lane or mid, and then Queen of Pain and Ogre Magi kind of paired up, and then the last pick, whatever offlaner, kind of left solo. But as much as we see Wiz Tiny, yeah, I think it's only it only can be Wiz Tiny. With Legion Commander, it's a super powerful dual offlane that is able to, because of the regeneration between the two of them, are super, super hard to kill. But I don't think that's going to be a possibility here. As it maybe if they had another range support, they could have put it with a safe lane farming Tiny and just had this kind of like safe lane farming Tiny while they had a Queen of Pain mid. But I'm thinking this is still going to be the Wiz Tiny mid. Queen of Pain, Ogre Magi in the farming up the safe lane, and then Legion Commander off lane. But we'll have to see. I mean, it still could be a safe lane Tiny. It's entirely possible. Even though it's been a while since we've seen Tiny anywhere but mid. This lineup is certainly well-rounded from the side of Union Gaming. I like it quite a lot. While the Not Today team is a bit more all-in on their Juggernaut, the sources of damage coming out is primarily going to be the Juggernaut. Broodmother isn't really a great team fighter and is known more for creating space than being able to provide amazing late-game teamfight. And then, of course, the Magnus is great at being able to set up good teamfights for his team, but doesn't necessarily provide a whole lot of damage as the game goes on. So unless you're building into one of those, like, semi-carry Magnuses, if you're building the traditional Magnus route, which is, like, Blink Dagger, Force Staff, and Refresher, then you don't really provide any damage on your own. That being said, of course, the Empower is going to be amazing with this Juggernaut as his Omni Slash, especially once he has a Mask of Madness and his attack speed is high enough that he can get hits in between Omni Slash hits. That Empower is going to be exceptionally amazing as the Juggernaut is able to do that much more damage in that big ultimate. But we'll see. Not Today is going to be running with a 5-man into the enemy jungle to start with. Now, Ifrit I wonder if they're going to try and bait this out at all. It's interesting what Ifrit's build is here. Maybe they're just trying to decide what they're going to be facing first before Ifrit commits. Because I doubt we're going to see a fast battle. Rylers is going to be stunned up here. Ben just goes for the stun onto Rylers as well. They're going to try and go for this Vengeful Spirit, but Xander is already being cleaned up here as the spin is enough to get that tanky Ogre Magi down. And now they're going for the Wiz too. A beautiful skewer is able to grab the Queen of Pain as well as that other support. But start out, first blood, double kill for Not Today. And what a way to start. Aggro tri lane for them, mid Magnus, and a Broodmother in the safe lane, it would seem. Broodmother's actually going to be starting out here, grabbing the bottom. Is Smash going all the way up to top lane?
This will do nicely.
Or, well, bottle first. Yeah, it's mid Broodmother. So this has been seen a couple of times. I'm actually a bit torn on how successful it is, but I don't think I've seen it versus Tiny Wisp, and maybe this is exactly what needs to be picked up here. Magnus wasn't going to do very well versus the Tiny Wisp. He can spam out Shockwave charges, and he can generally do all right, but he certainly wouldn't win the lane, so maybe this mid Broodmother is the best way to do it. If you guys haven't seen this before, the way Mid Broodmother works is that you set up, you only really need one web in this middle lane, obviously. If they push out really aggressively, you may need a second web behind you. But once you have level 3, you have webs to be able to cover both the rooms. So you can put a second web there, and maybe another web in by here. And you basically are always able to get the rune because it's too tough to contest a Broodmother underneath webs. So starting about the 4-minute mark, you should have guaranteed runes. And this is why you go for bottle on the Broodmother, because you're able to spam out the spawn spiderlings over and over and over again. Now, this leaves our top lane matchup a little bit easier for the Legion Commander than expected, as she's going to be facing up against the Legion Commander, very successful lane. And I actually forgot they had a Legion Commander. You don't want to put Broodmother versus a Legion Commander. It's not really a safe lane. Z-Talk, got to be careful here. Spawn Spiderlings, and he gets the kill. Ifrit, seeing an obvious opportunity there in order to get a kill on the Wisp, who plays way too far forward. Unfortunately, Ben just doesn't really have the mana to threaten that Broodmother anymore. Mystico sitting on that bottom rune with the aggro tri-lane they're running. Broodmother only has to address the top rune. And nice little bounty in order to increase the lead that you already have as the Broodmother. So they better hope the Legion Commander does well in that top lane and is able to create a big impact going into the mid-game. Because right now, Union Gaming are losing pretty much two of their lanes, I would say. This aggro try isn't going to be that successful because Queen of Pain is a great hero to deal with aggro try lanes. She can still have, she has great attack damage, great attack animation, and she obviously has the mobility thanks to that blink strike. So she should be perfectly fine and shouldn't really be caught out. And then the other support, the Ogre Magi, is really tanky. So while he shouldn't get caught out and he's very much in danger of dying if he does, he still at least has some tankiness to go for him. So they are definitely winning this aggro try, but it's not going to be a whole lot of kills. It's going to be more about controlling the lane and making sure the Queen of Pain doesn't see the opportunity to get a lot of farm. This will shut down that fast Orchid and in general keep the Queen of Pain from snowballing. Now they start running forward. They will be able to stun up Leo style, chain stun, and the blink away. Not going to be in time. Is the impact? Oh, it is! Holy cow, 7 health left on that Queen of Pain. I did not think she was going to make it out of there. I was like, oh, the impale stuns her up, and then like the spin to finish her off. But man, that was super close. The Juggernaut, almost wondering if maybe he regrets not going for that second level in Blade Fury. We see it only occasional nowadays. Oh god, the Wisp! Wisp! Oh god, the Spiderling's running after him. He's still going to fall here. Ifrit is going to die as well as the Toss is able to take him out. Ben just does get the return kill. So in the end, it is actually kind of worth it there for the side of Union Gaming, especially since the Broodmother was already so far ahead thanks to the Bounty Rune as well as the kill that she got earlier. Getting a free kill to Tiny is not that bad. So maybe things looking up a bit for Union Gaming. We got Ifrit here going still for that fast Orchid. Not a big surprise, especially up against many of these heroes, Tiny as well as Queen of Pain. Orchid should be very effective. And of course our Juggernaut is going for the traditional 1-1-1 build. It's a couple level in stats. Pretty standard. We only occasionally see Blade Fury even get a second level in it. And the only times we do see it is often is in aggro tri lanes where you're seeing a lot of action. These Spiderlings just keep on gunning for the Wisp. Now, if you take a look at Benj's CS, he's actually way ahead of everybody else, and that's because he's getting a lot of Broodling kills. It doesn't necessarily translate into a net worth lead, but the Broodmother does have to be careful of this, as with the Wisp, you can easily just spam out. Like right now, he could easily just spam out an Avalanche Toss and kill most of those Spiderlings and still be back up to full mana thanks to the Wisp bottle. Another counter ward laid down, and the Broodmother's playing this very passively, probably knowing that that Ogre Magi is mid. Smash, meanwhile, how's his lane going? Taking a look at the CS, 27-3 compared to 33-4. I would say that's about to be expected. But bottom lane, though, Benj's Mystico's going to be caught out here. Oh, no! Xander get the stun. He gets impaled up. Benji's not quite in range. They need a toss or something. He will be able to get the avalanche and the toss combination in range, as Benji's was just a bit too fast for that lion to outrun. But now that he doesn't have any mana, these spiderlings, they could start wrecking the tower pretty quickly if they're not careful. Greedy gets himself a haste rune and will continue to press the advantage he already has over the Magnus. Oh, a regen rune for the Wisp. That's a pretty big get right there. Rallers once again forcing away the Queen of Pain. And even denying that that coveted Siege Creep. Always feels good when you get the last hit on the Siege Creep. So much money. But yeah, Smash has got to just play this so careful because he can't afford to be caught out. Looks like they got the Queen of Pain. Oh man, they didn't even use Omni Slash for that. Looks like maybe Mystico maybe went for a dive here because he's quite low from diving that tower, but not even needing the Omni Slash. Well played. Ifrit 36 and 0 up against a dual lane. Very successful, and he's gotten two kills out of it as well. Radiant's bottom tower is under three kills, attack. Actually. Meanwhile, the aggro try, easily taking control of the tier 1 tower, is going to be falling soon. This matchup, though, Magnus managed to get the kill on the top lane, just making sure Ifrit doesn't see any more action at bottom. But yeah, Magnus managed to get that one, barely surviving, it looks like. As Yogur and Jai just not there in time. 2-6, Mask of Madness. Already up on Slarky. Goes to show how well they're farming now. This tier 1 tower, Mystico is trying to bait it out a little bit. If the Queen of Pain moves forward, they're going to try and get an impale. Leo Stomp not chancing the deny, instead just blinks out as soon as possible. Needs to make sure that she doesn't get caught, but a defensive lane where the Queen of Pain is sitting at level 4. I mean, it goes to show how well Not Today did in shutting down out this Quap. Smash, meanwhile, will grab himself another Bounty Rune. While the Broodmother gets the bottom rune for herself. Teleport in, and Slarky coming in hot. Smash is able to smash back Benji's and will be able to put him in a bad position as Slarky finishes off the Wisp. And Benji's, without any sort of hope of escape here after that beautiful rotation from Smash, they get the double. 2-8 now. Not Today continuing to press forward. We'll go for this tier 1 tower with the host of spiderlings that they have. Should be quite easy. Meanwhile, Greedy will do what he can to push in the top lane, see if he can't get that faster blink dagger, but not much he can do to really rotate out of that top lane. Without the blink dagger, you just really are not that viable of a hero. TP's in. We do have the Legion Commander. Cancels that TP. Maybe deciding was it going to be close enough. Rowlers, oh, we dodged the avalanche, but does not dodge the toss. That's not even possible. Spiderlings moving forward, going onto the Wisp. Toss will get a couple of those kills. Bottom lane, meanwhile, Slarky does not have. Yeah, they forced the blink. That was beautiful. Look at that setup. Slarky's going to be getting close enough here, and with that impale and the heavy amount of attack speed, they'll easily get the kill. Now the relocate in. Benji's is ready to go. They're going to try and get the kill on Mystico. 3 seconds until the impale's up. Benji's is in range and will be able to get the stun stoss combination. But at the same time, we have Slarky coming in from behind going for the Wisp. But the relocate out will serve him just fine. Stun toss combination. What a hard thing to say. Look at the tiny, though. That's Broodlings right there. 81 and 10. As you can see from his net worth, he's still not ahead. Middle lane looks like they're. Oh, no, there's going to be a turnaround here. Vengeance doesn't have a whole lot of mana, but with the Wisp coming back in, toss up in the air, will be able to finish off the Vengeful Spirit. Now Ifrit, trying to get himself out, does have a couple of webs in order to escape and will be fine, but already has that very early Orchid to start banking some kills. Juggernaut coming into the middle lane. 5 seconds until Omni Slash, and he'll be in a good position for it too. Benji's orchid it up. We have Smash missing the RP onto the Wisp. Won't be able to claim that one, but they'll still get both the kills. The Omni Slash finishes off the Wisp. Oh, oh no! We have Greedy able to grab Smash. Finally, the Tiny gets himself away, but Greedy does not have the damage to fight Slarky. But maybe with Leo style, he does. Gonna go for Mystico here on the side, who is gonna be blocked out by the Queen of Pain, but still, Queen of Pain gets blown up by the finger. Greedy gets the return kill, but it's still Slarky, who stays alive and is able to bounce himself out of there. 3-for-4 exchange. The Vengeful Spirit, did she not die? No, she died like really, really early on, so I don't think you could count that. So I think you can kind of call it a 3-for-3. As Rallards died a while before that fight. Slarky, though, I mean, this is the power of the Juggernaut. It's absolutely absurd, but being able to solo Roshan like this as soon as you have Mask of Madness and a little bit of extra damage is pretty insane. Even Smash using his Skewer in order to get into the pit and help tank up. With the Vengeful Spirit, it makes it that much easier. So Roshan will fall, and Aegis claim for the Juggernaut. Queen of Pain only just now getting level 6. Leo style, man. This guy is so far behind. At least they got Legion Commander. Ooh, that's a level 11 Legion Commander soon. He didn't actually get the experience for that last creep. I was thinking if he got the melee creep and the range creep, maybe he'd be level 6 or level 11. But they're going to try and go for the Broodmother here. But Ifrit is scared. And you can understand why. He's sitting in the lane of the Legion Commander. And he knows exactly the danger the Legion Commander imposes upon. He does see. Oh, this could be perfect. Greedy. Oh, no. He will just take all those spiderlings right there. But if he had gotten Ifrit inside of that one as well, managed to blink in, get the duel, that would have been a easy, easy kill. That heavy nuke from all the spiderlings. They maybe are going to get smashed instead. They will. The duel goes off, and the damage is just going to be fast enough with the relocate coming in as well. They ensure the kill. And that is now Agonins for the Tiny. I mean, as farmed as the Juggernaut is, they still got to worry about this Tiny. And the level 11 Agonins that he already has. Slarky is pushing in this tier 2 in the bottom lane. Not much Leo style can really do about this one. As if he gets caught out without his blink, Omni Slash easily kills him. Now, presumably, Mystico's going to be going for that blink dagger when he can. That tier 2 will certainly help put them on the road for that one. There's the eggs. And Tiny Smash ready to go. So now they have one more way to clear through the spiderlings, and now that's just like the regular auto attacks of the Tiny with that splash damage. Ifrit trying to push into that tier 1 tower, but he's definitely playing very careful with his spiderlings. Using them to scout out is a great call. But it's kind of like playing up against an Earthshaker that comes online a bit faster. Middle lane, we do have Slarky, who was able to grab. Oh, the duel not going to be enough, and now he's going to be able to get off the Omni Slash. Blows up the Wisp, going on Benjes, but that's not enough. One more hit, Benjes, toss, 1 second, not going to get there in time. As he starts healing up, toss, nope, doesn't even toss a creep onto him. Is going to be forced back. They got the Vengeful Spirit in exchange for the Wisp. So close to finishing off Slarky there in that duel, but because they didn't, not today, we'll take the opportunity to climb that tier 1 tower in the top lane. 10 to 13, 14 and a half minutes in. A close game so far, not today, still holding the advantage. They started off before the bell even rang. They started off with a decent golden experience lead off of those kills they got in the beginning and have been able to build on that ever since with the laning phase that they had. But Union Gaming, despite the fact that it looks pretty bad for Union Gaming right now, they do have big time recovery elements. First of all, they have really great late game in the Tiny Wisp, Legion Commander, as well as the Quap, all strong late game heroes. Hell, even the Ogre Magi is great. I would say not today's lineup is very much focused on the mid game. And if they can't shut down Union Gaming enough, if they can't get the pickoffs and push uphill and take that lane of racks, you could see Union Gaming just rat it out. They've got really great ratting heroes. Legion Commander with the mobility of Blink is actually pretty decent. Overwhelming odds, blink away. Queen of Pain, same thing, high amount of mobility. And then you have the Tiny Wisp, which combines mobility with tower pushing capabilities. So this game is going to be, I think, a lot closer than the net worth would currently say it is. How's the experience doing, by the way? Experience, yeah, a lot more even than the net worth. Obviously, because a lot more towers have fallen on the side of Not Today. It's why they have such a big gold lead. As far as items go, we've got the Aghanims up on benches. Legion Commander Blink trying to work towards that blade mail for obvious reasons. Going to be super effective versus the Juggernaut if you can finish it up in a short amount of time. Juggernaut, not really a hero that's going to be going BKB. You see it very occasionally, and it's only in those dire circumstances, like a game I have to go BKB. So it just means that blade mail is always going to be effective. Broodmother, another hero that it's okay at, but it's mainly the Juggernaut that's going to be feeling a lot of that pressure. Now, it looks like our Juggernaut is going to be going for... is this an Aghanim's build, or is this a Scotty build? He could have Aghanim's right now, but I think this is Scotty. He's got the Orb of Venom. Wow. So, Scotty first Juggernaut. Cart, give me some stats on that one. It's been seen a number of times here in DAC, not completely unheard of. But I'm just a bit surprised that this is the game that he chooses to go for it here.
Double damage.
Ifrits. Ever since the... Just Scotty in general. If you can follow that up with the item progression, though, that'll be interesting, too, because I believe the builds that we've seen on Juggernauts before hasn't been Scotty this early. And it's quite the early Scotty, man. I'm just not sure if this is going to be enough damage. Like, Scotty's a good all-around stat item. Right, it gives you longevity because you have a much higher HP pool. You're able to slow down these heroes. And then on top of that, it's decent stats. You know, agility, strength, all around. So it's a good all-around item, and it's amazing late game, but smoke-on-smoke action here. Doesn't look like they're going to find... Yeah, they're going to go for the Wisp here. Courier, they sneak right past that one because they want the kill. And with that one, oh yeah, that RP kind of ensures both of those heroes are dead. Especially with the Omni Slash on top of that now. Rallers keeps on playing aggressively, looking for more. They could get the Ogre Magi here. He's smoked up. If the Broodmother pops it... No, they're not going to go for it. Not yet, anyway. Though, those Spiderlings need to get out of here. I'm not sure what Ifrit's doing, but he just left those to the overwhelming odds. Stun up on Xander, but... No play just yet. Slarky pushing forward. Does have the Empower push ready to go. Union Gaming. They've got the blade mail. Greedy's got that. He kind of needs a pick off Ifrit. Oh, man. They kind of need a gem is what they need. They know this guy's here. Now he got him too. Ifrit, he didn't realize he was sitting on a ward, and that'll be a one duel for Greedy. If he just stayed invisible, it would have been fine. The Mom Yasha Eye has only been done two other times. Fast is by far 17 minutes. Wow. The previous record is 26 minutes. Oh, man. Slarky is going ham here. Maybe we've got a new star player. Maybe it's not all about Smash. Maybe it's now about Slarky. Because this is impressive. How many times has been Scotty built just in general on Juggernaut? 10% of games. So 31 games in total. Nice. Thank you, Cart. That is that is actually, like, amazingly fast how quickly Slarky is able to get this Scotty. I mean, like, if you look at Scotty timings in general, like, this is probably the fastest. I think he said it was fastest Scotty on Juggernaut, straight up. But if you look at Scotty timings as a whole, this has got to be one of the faster ones out there. And the thing is, this game is still even. Like, it's not just a blowout right now. Mikkel's 21 minutes. Top lane, Ifrit. They're going for him. Benjes. Well, he'll take the Spiderling kills. Meanwhile, though, while they don't get that kill, they're also leaving them exposed to this push. Larky. Again, with the empower and the physical damage he has, the high amount of attack speed. He is a tower chopper, man. He's able to take that one. Now they jump in, but can they save him? The swap goes out. RP is able to control some of those heroes on the blow from the Queen of Pain, but it's not enough. Omni Slash bouncing around, going on Benjes, but he's able to tank a lot of it. Greedy will survive, gets the kill, even Smash. He's not living for long. He charges away from the Queen of Pain. Even Rowlers goes down. Three heroes out as Union Gaming strike back hard there in the middle lane. They got the tier two, but good God, they gave up a nasty team fight for Union Gaming. 14-16, and I would say Union Gaming back in this game, like, pretty handedly. That's got to be quite the sizable gold and experience. Probably a lot of experience. Yeah, jump up. Looks like a good 2,000 experience. Manta picked up now by the Tiny. And again, like, you can't put this Tiny and Juggernaut on the same level. Juggernaut has to be items ahead of this Tiny, because the Tiny is just too much. Oh, look at all those delicious spiderlings. Tiny wants some. Tony's hungry. Excellent initiation, though, by Union Gaming. That's what they have to do. They didn't quite get it, but it was still enough to win the fight. Initiate on the Juggernaut. Lock him down with some with a duel. That's got to be the play. He still got off the Omni Slash, but they just kind of rolled over the enemy team, mainly because Smash, first of all, kind of whiffed. Like, he got an RP, but it wasn't the greatest. And then the Queen of Pain. That was a great ultimate from her. Hit three, maybe four heroes. Decent scream on top of it as well. The AoE just wiped out Not Today. Let's see, what's our... yeah, Mystico's got his Blink Dagger. He did save up for that one. Hasn't now. So he's looking all right. What else do we got? Queen of Pain. Is this a... I wonder what the Queen of Pain does. Like, when you're shut down so hard, do you build BKB? Do you go, well, I'm nothing really but my ultimate. Do you go Aghanim's? Like, you got to get some... If you want to go late game, you got to get some farm back into this. A BKB-only co-op is not terribly effective, especially since a lot of the damage coming out from Not Today is physical. Or there are lockdowns that go through BKB, right? So, I mean, she either is going to build BKB and is that afraid of the lion. Or I guess goes for, well, what is Xander doing here? Jesus, dude. Skewer? Oh, he got him. Smash. Mi pastor. Good God. Xander. He goes down. I don't know what that was. Xander just, like, threw away his life there. He pops out, stuns, and then dies. It's pretty much what that was. Like, that TP was... not going to work. And now look at that. Roshan time. 14-17. 23 minutes in. We got Roshan. Aegis. For Slarky. Dire's middle tower is under attack. But at the same time, Benjes is getting space and he's getting big. He's level 16. He actually is actually literally getting big. He just got his level 3 grow and is going to be having an assault Kira soon. And this is the point where Tiny, like, hell, they could just relocate on this tier 1 tower if they wanted to and just beat it to death real quickly. Obviously, not the most efficient use of relocate. You need to save it right now. Slarky was just charging forward. Not Today. You're going to go for the ever solid strategy of run at them. And we'll be trying to go for this tier 3 tower. Now, Slarky is forced to use Blade Fury there. He backs himself away. A little bit too dangerous to be caught out by the multicast. It's, I mean, pretty long duration stun if you get a couple of multicasts. Well, actually, he's only level 1 multicast so far, so. But still, the follow-up there of the avalanche toss could burst him down. And that first life, you don't want to give up so easily. But if he can claim the tower for it, and he does so far, Healing Ward keeping him quite healthy. They need to initiate soon. We've got Greedy on the left side. He needs to be the initiator here. Slark is going to be able to get off his spin and takes down the melee racks for free. As Union Gaming don't put much of a fight. Now overwhelming odds. Tosses some of them back. Union Gaming. I think they realize if they take a bad fight here, this could be the end of the game. Greedy, though, running forward so aggressively. And do you really want to use your duel on an Aegis hero? I don't think so. Slarky now goes bottom. They're not going to give Union Gaming any time to recover. They're going to keep on pushing. And this is the best way to punish them for their passive actions. Healing Ward still keeping Slarky very much healthy, and he's got a lot of HP. For a Juggernaut, you aren't supposed to have this much HP. He's got 2100 thanks to BKB as well as his Eye of Scotty. Now the swap in, Benj is in some trouble. Relocate out, but it's not in time. The Omni Slash takes down. And now the duel, well, he was able to get the Magnus. At the very least, stops that one, but it's already been taken out by Slarky and Ifrit, the combination. The buyback there from the Queen of Pain, but it looks like it's over. Not today. Now going to be able to take their second set of racks. They can't take the full game, but they will cripple Union Gaming after that small team fight. Unfortunately, no buyback. Xander, oh god, he got way too close. He goes down, just feeding extra kills away. And unfortunately, our Tiny was only 30 gold away. But even then, like, I'm not sure if, like, they just lost that team fight so handedly. And they had Smashback with the RP, so even the trade-off of the Legion Commander there wasn't really worth it. Oh, Z-Tuck Smash is able to ensure that extra kill, so now it's just the Queen of Pain. As they push forward, able to take that range racks, and I guess they're just going to go straight for Throne. The Tier 2 was still up in the top lane, so they decide to try and end it right here, right now. Orchid onto Leo style. Oh no, he's going to lose his life right in front of the fountain, potentially. Orchid, not quite enough. Oh boy. Not today. Almost fountain farming heroes. Highest net worth at 25 minutes. Slarky, man, making a big splash so far, and he's going to keep on going for it. Xander slowed down by the Scotty, trying to get some help here, but he's got nobody here. With Impale, Greedy moving forward as well, trying to get some help. Benjes, he will duel up Slarky, but oh, just gets torn to pieces there. As now Benjes, left alone, is able to take down the Lion, but he's surrounded on all sides. How many Craggy exterior procs can he get? Not enough. He falls. He's got another buyback. Starts charging in. Omni Slash. Oh, Jesus. Slarky. Hey, go all in, man. He will die. He'll lose his Aegis, but he's got the whole entire team behind him. Benj is fighting to get back to the fountain. Slarky pops his Manta and runs back to addressing these Tier 4s that they started, feels like, so long ago. And sure enough, Union Gaming will call it game number one. Not today, taking it quite well. I mean, there was a chance at a comeback for Union Gaming. They had a chance to come back in this game. They had a, like, decent net worth. They had a good, pretty good farmed Tiny, but Slarky, man, that guy just tore it up. Forget Smash. Forget about me, Pastor. It's all about Slarky. I don't know what the Spanish term is for him, but good God. That guy just tore it up. 12-1-10. With an aggro tri-lane Juggernaut. 835 gold per minute. Very well done, but that's just game one, guys. That is just game one. The new lineup of Not Today looking pretty good. But we'll see whether or not they can take game number two. As it feels like maybe Juggernaut is just not a hero you want to give to Not Today. That's scary. That's scary, man, but all around Union Gaming, definitely got to go back to the drawing board. Think of maybe a bit different strategy when it comes to draft and come back to game two, hitting strong because they do not want to be going down 2-0 up against probably their biggest rivals in South America, not today. So stick around, guys. Game number two coming up in just a short break.